Hi friends, how are you? In this video, we are going to learn about the capsules or coverings for kidney. There are four coverings or capsules for kidney. Number one, true capsule. Number two, perinephric fat. And number three, false capsule. Number four, paranephric fat. Okay. In previous video, we learned about the location, shape, dimensions or measurements, external features and the relations, both anterior and posterior for both the right and left kidneys, and the structures that entering and exiting at hilum. Okay, coming to the topic, I told you guys that that is in anterior to posterior direction, that is about VAP, V-A-P. Vein, artery, pelvis, and the last one is that is the subsidiary artery that coming from the renal artery. Okay, you check that video. Coming to the topic, capsules are coverings of kidney. From within outwards, the kidney is surrounded by four capsules or coverings as follows. Number one, fibrous capsule, also called true capsule, perirenal, and it also called perinephric fat, renal fascia or false capsule, pararenal or paranephric fat. These are the four coverings or capsules of kidney. First one is, I show you guys, it may give you clarity. And this is the this structure. This is the kidney, okay, and the capsule that surrounding this kidney is renal capsule. We call this as renal capsule. This is nothing but true capsule or fibrous capsule, and the next capsule or covering that surrounding this true capsule, we call this as perinephric fat. It is a layer of adipose tissue just its surrounding true capsule, okay, and the capsule that surrounding this perinephric fat is fascia. This is renal fascia. We call this as false capsule of kidney, okay. And this is the paranephric fat, also called as pararenal or paranephric fat. Okay, I think it is clear. These are the four structures: renal capsule, perinephric fat, renal fascia, and paranephric fat. We learn about everything. First, fibrous capsule or true capsule. It is a thin membrane which closely envelops the kidney. It is formed by condensation of fibrous connective tissue. In the peripheral part of kidney. It readily stripped off from the surface of normal kidney. The capsule passes through the hilum to line the renal sinus and becomes continuous with the walls of calyces where they are attached with the kidney. If the kidney is inflamed, this capsule becomes firmly adherent to the organ and can't be stripped off. Once again, it is a thin membrane closely enveloped kidney formed by condensation of fibrous connective tissue in peripheral part of kidney, okay, and readily stripped off from surface of normal kidney. Okay, we can easily remove this. Okay, stripped off from normal kidney. Okay. The capsule passes through the hilum to line the renal sinus and becomes continuous with the calyces where they are attached with kidney. The capsule passes through the hilum to line the renal sinus. This is the true capsule. It passes through the hilum. Okay. To surround or to continue with the renal sinus and becomes continuous with the wall of calyces where they are attached with the kidney. If the kidney is inflamed, this capsule becomes firmly adherent to the organ and can't be stripped off. I think it is clear. Next is perirenal or perinephric fat. It is a layer of adipose tissue surrounding the fibrous capsule of the kidney. This is the perinephric fat. It is a layer of adipose tissue which surrounding the true capsule of kidney. Okay. It fills the space inside the loosely fitting sheath of renal fascia enclosing the kidney and suprarenal gland. It fills the space inside the loosely fitting sheath of renal fascia enclosing the kidney and suprarenal gland. This is the perinephric fat. It fills the space that loosely fitting between the renal fascia and renal capsule. Okay. And it covers the both kidney and it surrounds both kidney as well as the suprarenal gland. This is the suprarenal gland. And this is the adipose tissue that is perinephric. This and this both is the perinephric fat. Okay. And it surrounds both the suprarenal gland and kidney. Okay. I think it is clear. And this fatty capsule is thick at the borders of kidney and is prolonged through hilum into the renal sinus. This fatty capsule is thickest at the borders of kidney and is prolonged through the hilum into the renal sinus. In chronic debilitating diseases, the depletion of perinephric fat can cause downward displacement of kidney, which may lead to the kinking of ureter. This is the kinking of ureter. It is caused due to the in chronic debilitating diseases, the depletion of perinephric fat can cause the downward displacement of kidney. This causes the downward. Actually, this kidney is in some position high. When due to the depletion of this fat, perinephric fat, actually this kidney is like this, from like this. But due to the depletion of this fat, it causes the downward movement of this kidney and causes the kinking of ureter. Okay, this downward movement of kidney causes the kinking of ureter. Once again, in chronic debilitating diseases, the depletion of perinephric fat can cause downward displacement of kidney, which may lead to the kinking of ureter. Kinking of ureter due to the perinephric fat. This is the figure that shows the kinking of ureter. Okay. Next, coming to renal fascia, false capsule, fascia of Garota. Okay, it is a fibroareolar sheath which surrounds the kidney and perirenal fat. It consists of the following two layers: an ill-defined anterior layer, a well-defined posterior layer. An ill-defined anterior layer is called fascia of Told. A well-defined posterior layer is called fascia of Jagerkandel. Okay, once again, anterior T, A, T, at, piz. Pizza, P-I-Z-Z-A, okay? P-Z, H, at, where, at? A-T, that is fascia of Told. Once again, it is a fibroareolar sheath which surrounds the kidney and perirenal fat. It consists of two layers, a ill-defined, that means poorly defined, that may be not at all defined anterior layer. It is a fascia of Told. And well-defined posterior layer, it is called fascia of Jagerkandel. Extensions. This layer is the renal fascia, also called false capsule, or also called fascia of Garota. Okay, this surrounds the kidney as well as perinephric fat. Okay guys, coming to the topic. Remember what I told, renal fascia, also called false capsule, also called fascia of Garota. It is a fibrous sheath which surrounds the kidney as well as perirenal fat. It has two layers, one anterior and one posterior layer. Anterior one is ill-defined and the name for this is fascia of Told, and posterior layer, it is well defined. This layer we called as fascia of Jagerkandel. Okay, coming to the extensions. Superiorly, the two layers first enclose the suprarenal gland in a separate compartment and then fuse with each other and becomes continuous with the diaphragmatic fascia. Superiorly, suprarenal gland in a separate compartment and then fuse with each other and become continuous with the diaphragmatic fascia. If you observe this diagram, this is the renal fascia. Superiorly, first in two separate layers that enclose the suprarenal gland. This is the one layer and this is the another layer. Okay, two separate layers that enclose the suprarenal gland and its fuse. And it continues as diaphragmatic fascia. Continues with the diaphragmatic fascia. Okay, I think it is clear, guys. Inferiorly, the two layers remain separate and enclose the ureter. The anterior layer is gradually lost in the extraperitoneal tissue of iliac fossa, while the posterior layer blends with the fascia iliaca. Once again, inferiorly two layers remain separate and enclose the ureter. And inferiorly, this remain separate, okay, and it continues with the ureter, okay. In this figure, not shown, guys. Okay, once again, we read for better understanding. Once again, inferiorly, two layers remain separate and enclose the ureter. Anterior layer is gradually lost in the extraperitoneal tissue of iliac fossa, while the posterior layer blends with the fascia iliaca. Posterior layer blends with the fascia iliaca, and anterior layer it lost in extraperitoneal tissue of iliac fossa. And next, laterally, the two layers unite firmly and become continuous with fascia transversalis. Laterally, two layers unite and firmly and become continuous with the fascia transversalis. If you observe this diagram, this is the true capsule, and this space is surrounded by the perinephric fat, and this is the false capsule, also called false fascia or fascia of Gerretum, and the two layers firmly join and it continues as fascia transversalis, okay. In lateral side, okay, not at medial, it is at lateral side. What in lateral side, what happens? Laterally, two layers unite firmly and become continuous with fascia transversalis. I think it is clear. Next, medially, anterior layer passes in front of kidney. Anterior layer passes in front of the kidney and renal vesicles and merges with connective tissue surrounding the aorta and inferior vena cava. And the posterior layer passes behind the kidney and is attached to fascia covering the quadratus lumborum and psoas major. Medially, anterior layer passes in front of the kidney and renal vesicles and merge with the connective tissue that surrounding the aorta and inferior vena cava. And this anterior layer that surrounds the kidney as well as renal vesicles, okay, and merge with the connective tissue that surrounding the aorta and merge with the connective tissue that surrounding the aorta as well as inferior vena cava. Once again, it has two, that anterior and posterior divided into two. it is anterior, and this is the posterior. This is the anterior, and this is the posterior. Okay, this anterior ones surrounds the or covers the kidney as well as renal vesicles and continue with the connective tissue that surrounding the aorta as well as inferior vena cava. Next, coming to the posterior. Medially, the posterior layer passes behind the kidney and is attached to the fascia covering the quadratus lumborum and psoas major. And this is the posterior layer that surrounds the behind the kidney, and it continues with the fascia that surrounding or that covering the both quadratus lumborum and psoas major. Okay, this is the quadratus lumborum and this is the psoas major. Okay, I think it is clear. Next, that at the medial end of the kidney, two layers are attached by a connective tissue septum being pierced by the renal vesicles. Because of this attachment or septum, perirenal effusion of fluids does not usually extend across the opposite perirenal space. At the medial border of the kidney, two layers are attached by a connective tissue septum being pierced by the renal vesicles. Because of this attachment, perirenal effusion of the fluid does not usually extend across into the opposite perirenal space. Okay. Next is, read this point once again, guys. It has some importance that you have to remember must. And pararenal paranephric fat. It is a layer of fat lying outside the renal fascia. It consists of considerable quantity of fat being more abundant posteriorly and toward the lower pole of the kidney. It fills the paravertebral gutter and forms a cushion for the kidney. Once again, read that point. Next, pararenal or paranephric fat. It is a layer of fat lying outside the renal fascia. It consists of considerable quantity of fat being more abundant posteriorly and toward the lower pole of kidney. It fills the paravertebral gutter. And forms a cushion for the kidney. This is the paranephric fat. It has abundant and it is more at the lower pole and posterior side, and it is present more at the paravertebral gutter, and it forms the cushion for the kidney. Okay. This diagram is so important, guys. Okay, try to remember this. I show you the parts for you. This is the costo diaphragmatic recess. This is the diaphragm. This is the diaphragmatic fascia, and this is the renal fascia. Superiorly, it continue this renal fascia or false capsule continuous with the diaphragmatic fascia superiorly. Okay. 12th rib. So it is right kidney. Okay. Vein artery. Now van, V-A-N. V-A-N. Okay, guys. V-A-N. Okay, subcostal vein, subcostal artery and subcostal vein. And the other two nerves are ileo-hypogastric nerve, ileo-inguinal nerve. And the muscle is quadratus lumborum iliac crest. Okay. True capsule. Perinephric fat. False capsule, renal fascia. Paranephric fat. Diagram is so important. Practice. Okay. Kidney, true capsule, this space occupied by perinephric fat, and this is the renal fascia, and laterally it continues with the fascia transversalis. Okay, and when coming to medially, anteriorly, it is continuous with the connective tissue that surrounds the aorta and inferior vena cava. Okay, and it posteriorly, it is behind, it runs behind the kidney, and it surrounds the fascia that covering the quadratus lumborum and psoas major. Okay. This is the topic in this video. If you like this video, like, share and subscribe. Thank you.